Hi, today we'll be making baklava. I'm going to show you, I'm just going to do my syrup at the beginning. I'm going to put my syrup on and then I will start doing my baklava. So here I have 4 cups of sugar, and to that I'm going to be adding, I have 5 small sticks of cinnamon, and I have, how many? There are 8, 9. 9 pieces of cardamom. So as you can see, the cardamom, and I have 2 cups of water. That's also gonna go. And later, I will be adding some lemon juice and a blossom water for the flavor and taste. So now I'm going to add my cinnamon and cardamom and my water. I'm going to stir my sugar and until my sugar is dissolved, and it's gonna go on the stove. As soon as it comes to the boil, I'm gonna bring it to the medium high and leave it on for 5 to 6 minutes, and I'll show you how it looks when it's supposed to be. Okay, here is my water. It's been on for like 5 minutes. As you can see, it's still boiling. It's syrup, it's not done yet. I'm going to add here's my lemon. I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons. So just a squirt and a squirt that goes in. And I also have this honey. Do you see it? I also have this honey. So I'm gonna put about maybe 1/4 cup of honey. It's gonna give a good flavor. So 1/4 cup, that's done too. So I'm gonna let my syrup to boil again, and it needs to boil more. I'll show you when it's done. So as you can see, my syrup is, do you see all these bubbles on top? So it's almost done. I just need to put a tablespoon of the blossom water. I need to put in that too for the flavor. This one here. So it's gonna go in. As I said, it's too strong, so we don't want too much. You need to put that at last, because you know when a sugar boils, it's gonna splash of the water out of it, out of itself. So we don't want that. So it's done. Now I'm going to put my heat. Actually, for the last couple minutes, I put it on a little bit high, just to see I got all the bubbles right. So my sugar is done. I'm turning it off. It's gonna be sitting here to get cold. So it has to be kind of really cold. When it cools down, I'm probably gonna put it in the fridge. I want it really cold before I put it on my baklava. So this is done, and gonna continue with my baklava. Hi, so here's my ingredients for my baklava filling. I have here 4 cups of walnuts. I grind it in my food processor. So it's really up to you if you wanna grind. I grind it a little bit fine, but you can grind it just the way you want it. And these are things that are going into my walnuts. I have 2 tablespoons of sugar, and I have a one teaspoon of cinnamon powder, and a 1 teaspoon of cardamom. So it's this kind of, this ground cardamom. And this are gonna go into my walnuts. And I have one tablespoon of blossom water. It's very strong, so you don't put too much. The smell is also great and awesome, but it's just too strong. So I'm gonna be adding my powders to here, and I'm going to add my blossom water, and then here's my phyllo dough. I use this kind of phyllo dough for my wrapping, and here I will also add. I don't have my butter ready yet, but I'm going to have 2 tablespoons of margarine, then melted margarine or butter. Gonna be also green in here. I'll show you what kind, and I'll mix it, and it'll be ready to go for my baklava. Okay, so now I'm ready to do my make my baklava. As I said, I use this kind of butter. It's unsalted margarine, and I have melted it in the microwave. So I'm going to put, as I said, 2 tablespoons. I'm gonna put on my filling. So just like that, and I will stir it. So I don't want it to be too dry so it doesn't fall off the baklava easily. So I just want all of it to be coated. Just like that. And I have my baking tray here. So I'm gonna be making a diamond shape one. So I'm gonna use two packages. So this is all here, one package, and I'm gonna use the second package. So I'll be using two packages for this So I'm going to butter my tray. And you can use brush if you like, but I use my hands, so I don't have a brush. So I'm going to put my sheet underneath it. I hope it fits. So it's a little bit too big, actually. My sheets are too long for it. And in this case, what I have to do is I have to trim it. When I'm done, I have to trim it. I wanted a bigger dish. So what I do, I'm going to butter every sheet like this. If you got a bigger tray that to fit your sheet perfectly, it's great. You don't have to cut the extra because believe me, when you make baklava, you need every little bit of it. So I'm going to put, I'm going to keep continuing this. Okay, so I cut my sheet. It was a little bit too long. I wanted it really to fit because when I put my syrup, I needed to go everywhere. So I cut it to the same size of my pan. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put like 10 sheets, and I'm going to put some of my, I'm gonna pour some of my walnuts on, and then until I finish whole package. So every 10 sheets, I'm going to put some until I finish my whole box of phyllo dough, and then we'll do the middle part. So I'm gonna continue doing it. This is my 10th one, I guess. So as you can see, if you cut, it fits better. I'm going to put, I'm just gonna sprinkle some of my walnuts. So just like that, not too much, because this is my this is not my final layer though. So I'm gonna put it. So like this. So every 10 sheets I'm gonna do this until I finish my whole packaging. And I'll show you when my first package is done. So one of my boxes done. This is my second box. So for the middle, I'm gonna put my walnut. So I'm gonna, don't put too much because it's not easy when you lift it up, it's gonna fall. So if I put enough. So I'm gonna keep doing this, the whole package on top. And when this is all done too, I'm just gonna keep buttering and layering it. After 6 sheets, I'm gonna sprinkle some more and I'll show you how the end looks. So here's it all done, and I said I was gonna cut diamond, but I'm gonna cut a square this time. So I'll be just cutting it. You can cut any sizes you like, but I think this size is enough. So you can just kind of get it shape as you want before you cut it. So I'm just gonna see how many I can get. So I don't want them too big and too small, so. And that's gonna be, and there's gonna be one small and big, but that's okay. So that's how you're gonna cut. So I'm gonna start cutting. Get a sharp knife and go deep. So if you have to hold it, hold it. So I'm going to continue cutting all down, and then I'll show you with the other side.
Cut it.
It's all cut. Now I'm going to cut, make it a square. So again, we're just going to see how many you can get in this. So just like that, I'm going to continue to finish it up, and I bought a little more, and it's going to go in the oven on 350 degrees on the top. So it's going to be for 20 minutes or so, and every 5 minutes I have to check, just make sure that it doesn't burn. And I'll show you when it's done. Yeah, my square baklavas are done, and as you can see, they're really golden brown, and they look great. Now they're ready to put on syrup. Here's my syrup. It's not too cold because I just made it before I start making it, but it's okay. So I'm going to just pour it like this. My pistachio grounded, I'm going to garnish it with, and I'll show you how to do that. You can put it as much as low you like, but I don't want too much, just to garnish. So I'm gonna put like this. So here you are. And it's ready to be served. And I hope you enjoy making it and eating it.